August 2008, Denver, Colorado. Tim Pawlenty heads the McCain campaign's rebuttal team at the DNC.
Senator Obama, what have you done and what have you run?
What really drew the cameras? Speculation the Minnesota governor would soon join the Republican ticket.
Are you going to be vice president? Do you want the job?
I am going to be vice president of my fantasy football league.
Sports was Pawlenty's passion. As a kid growing up in the 60s in a blue-collar South St. Paul neighborhood, his father, Gene, was a delivery truck driver and dispatcher. His mother, Jenny, a homemaker who died of cancer when Tim was 16. Just a few years later, he caught the political bug inspired by Ronald Reagan.
It cheapens the process.
He won a seat in the legislature in 1992, became House Majority Leader in 99, and set his sights on the U.S. Senate, or so it seemed.
I am going to not pursue exploring the United States Senate.
Vice President Dick Cheney called to ask Pawlenty to step aside to clear the way for then-Mayor Norm Coleman of St. Paul, the White House pick to challenge incumbent Paul Wellstone. Pawlenty switched gears and ran instead for governor. He captured the GOP endorsement in a bruising state convention fight that went into the wee hours.
It's one thing to show up, it's quite another to stay till 3 in the morning. Thank you very much.
On that same pivotal night, Tim Pawlenty made a pledge never to raise taxes to balance the budget. And that put him on a collision course with Democrats who, for years, would accuse him of putting good politics ahead of sound fiscal policy.
I'm the only candidate in this race who won't raise your taxes.
Election night brought victory, but the ballroom euphoria soon gave way to the reality of an ocean of red ink. Democrats charged that Pawlenty merely shifted the load to school districts, cities, and counties, forcing them to raise property taxes to pick up the slack.
We think taxes based on ability to pay is a better idea.
Can't believe the Senate DFL majority is proposing this. It is profoundly stupid.
But his no new taxes vow rang hollow, especially to smokers, when he settled the 2005 budget stalemate with a 75-cent per pack tax and called it a health impact fee. Pawlenty used the veto stamp more than any other Minnesota governor, but
here we go.
Yeah.
He did sign the smoking ban into law and other green measures Democrats pushed.
There you go.
Including a landmark bill setting renewable energy targets. He also worked with Democrats on a bill to ramp up ethanol fuel standards.
The Saudi Arabia of new renewable fuels in this country, there's a dragon on the loose and he's wrecking stuff.
On the education front, he launched QCOMP, a pilot program for performance pay for teachers. But he also took heat for accounting shifts that forced local schools to borrow money.
President George W. Bush.
By 2006, Bushbackers were in jeopardy. Attorney General Mike Hatch had a reasonable chance to unseat Pawlenty until the final week of the campaign when he lashed out at a reporter.
And he kept going on and badgering. I said, listen, you're acting like a Republican hack.
Pawlenty beat Hatch by 1%, winning a second term on a night Republicans across the country lost big.
Shout out to a few people who I'm really grateful for. The first is my red-hot smoking wife.
That would be Mary Pawlenty. The two met at the U of M Law School, married in 1987, and settled in Eagan, where they raised their two daughters, Anna and Mara. The First Lady, a former judge, spearheaded the governor's program to support military families. There were troubles. The collapse of the 35W bridge claimed 13 lives and put transportation money issues under a microscope.
And House File 2800 is repassed.
Lawmakers overrode a Pawlenty veto in order to raise the fuel taxes for roads and bridges. The same week, they fired Lieutenant Governor Carol Molnow from her second job as Transportation Commissioner. But Pawlenty's national profile continued to rise, as did the VP questions.
What do you think? What are his chances?
But in reality, McCain's staff had thoroughly vetted Pawlenty and placed him high on the list of running mates.
I knew we should have stopped.
Sarah Palin got the nod instead, leaving Pawlenty to plot a new course.
You know, my dream job is to be an NHL defenseman, but at 48 and having no skill, it's tough.
In June of 2009, the governor announced he wouldn't seek a third term. That fall, he began to spend more of his weekends in the early primary states, such as Iowa.
I'm Tim Pawlenty, and I'm running for president of the United States.
Although he had a big head start at Iowa, Pawlenty found himself eclipsed in the polls by fellow Minnesotan Michelle Bachmann.
All right.
In August, the Pawlenty campaign staked everything on the Iowa straw poll. After placing a distant third to Bachman in Ames, Pawlenty decided to leave the race.
Probably would have done it differently, but we gave it our best shot, took it as far as we could.
For the Care 11 Extra, I'm John Croman.